In this challenge, we're going to try and add sound to the file. All these sounds were made with the SFXer website, so you can use them from the zip if you prefer, or you can make your own. Now for the actual file, in the blob, we're going to need to do a little bit of a modification to the file itself. When we initially made the blob, it was just a static object. But this time around, we want to have different states for the blob to be in. So in this case, we have labels. We can have the initial label of just the blob as it should be. And then as it deteriorates in health or whatever is going to happen to it, we can change its state to go to those other ones. So we have a way to call those different frames by using labels. Labels are up in the properties on the right hand corner there. And if you kind of stretch out the timeline a little bit, you can actually read the label you typed into the properties box. Now, the other thing you want to do is make an ActionScript 3 layer. That's where your code will be to stop things. And then you want to have a sounds layer. That's so that you can see visually where you add your sounds and how long they run for. Next up, we're going to modify the code. Make sure that every time we click, the gotoAndPlay goes specifically to the damaged label that we've just set up, so that we can have the sound play and we can also see the effect. Now repeat the process by just copying these over so that you've got three of these damaged clips. Each of them has the same label, which is going to cause us some problems in a minute, but for the moment what it does is it just gives you the visual of what's happening, which means every single time we click play, we go to the next frame, plays the sound, we lose a part of the blob, so the visual aspect of it, and we pause because of the ActionScript stop. So here's the second bit getting bitten out. And then you do the same thing for the third bit. Once that's done, what we're going to do is change the gotoAndPlay to just play, and we're going to change the health to 4 so we can actually see the effects of what we've just created. Now go back and clean up your keyframes if you've got duplicates of anything, such as the text field. Get rid of those keyframes with Shift F6, otherwise the number will keep resetting rather than going down as it should. Now you're ready to add in that final effect of the game over. Not specifically game over, but the blob is now completely finished and dead. So it will have this longer explosion sound, which you can see here. And that'll give you the indication that you've done it. You've managed to destroy that blob. The final step in the process is to get rid of the gaps. So for readability, we had lots of these gaps between the keyframes, but it actually causes them some problems by people being able to click too quickly. So we just need to get rid of those gaps. Shift F5 will do that for you. You don't need it on the last one, and that'll fix it up for you. And here is what the final file should look like.